Okay. Slightly less than a week ago, the Dutch government declared a full lockdown for Corona. We already had tickets for the movie The Matrix 4, that was supposed to be tomorrow. This is the first time in my life that I'm grateful for the lockdown. I hate the lockdown. Lockdown is a fucking nightmare. I think everyone in the Netherlands is shruggingly sick and tired of the lockdown. But if there hadn't been a lockdown, tomorrow I would have seen The Matrix in one of the best cinemas, Tuschinski in here in Amsterdam, one of the best cinemas in the world. And I would have had to see that in the cinema, and I would have then had to stand up, throw stuff at the screen and walk away or be escorted out with security. Comparatively, the Star Wars prequels, which are bad, and then the Star Wars sequels, which are even worse, are less bad than Matrix 4. I can go by the list, just pure logistics. The acting was horrible. The casting was weird. It was wooden. The special effects were, I don't know, infantile. Like they made me feel like something. What's that horrible director with the explosions?
Bane.
Michael Bay. Yeah, it was Michael Bay with a low budget. The CGI was, I don't know. There was no story to speak of. It was a story basically, and I'm going to do spoilers in here.
Spoilers if
Neo is insane. He is a psychiatric patient. He was hidden in a different life. Everyone sees him differently than he really is. He misses something, and he doesn't even remember what it is. And then he encounters a Trinity, which is now Tiffany, in a sort of a Starbucks with green, and they feel something. So he meets his ex that he knew 20 years ago. She's married with several kids, and they're in San Francisco. And I'm getting more frantic as I try to relate what I just saw. I downloaded it, and I would have gone to the cinema tomorrow, but I won't. I will not see The Matrix 4 ever again. I will not watch it ever again. I will not go to the cinema ever again. I will ignore the existence of this. I will cherish in my heart Matrix 1, 2, 3. I will cherish Animatrix. Those were statements of a bygone age, and that age is gone now. It's forever gone. I kind of could say that Matrix 4 broke my heart a little. It is. I have respect for Lana Wachowski for several reasons. I liked Sense8. The only thing that was positive here that I got to see a few people from Sense8 that were in this movie, and they had like little plugs in their heads, and they were now Matrix carriers. So the characters from Sense8 were now ported into the Matrix. And it wasn't even the Matrix as I knew it. It was some kind of Disney Matrix with flying birds, and it was Star Trek, and there was a hologram doctors there, and there were a few old characters, and there were the Morpheus. The Merovingian was there as a homeless person, and he was screaming, and I couldn't make out what he was screaming, but it was horrible. And it was in a sort of like a theatrical shack. They were fighting and they were breaking bits of wood and throwing. Fuck, man. This was so bad. How would you qualify it? How bad do you think it was? How bad was The Matrix 4?
I have trouble recollecting whatever is it that happened in the movie just after I watched it.
I try to discern some kind of hidden woke politically correct message in the movie, but it wouldn't say it gone over my head, because there is no intellectual. It was just a few jokes, but the jokes didn't come across. It was bad. I sincerely encourage you to not go and watch this movie. The action is bad. The special effects are bad. The story is ghastly. He finds Trinity and he kisses her. I don't know it, and that's it. And they're old. And then they go in and out of the Matrix a few times, and it's a sort of a cunning plan. And no. Last week, a few days ago, we saw in the cinema, we saw Spider-Man Homecoming. No?
No Way Home.
No Way Home. That was actually, I'm not going to do any spoilers about that. It was actually hilariously funny. I recommend going to see that. So if you want to have a sort of a bird's eye view of the last 20 years, it was like an albatross swooping through the skies, and then you see Spider-Man over the last 20 years. And it warms your heart to see No Way Home, Spider-Man No Way Home. It's funny. It is really funny at times. And the dialogues are, wow, just genius. It's a good movie. Comparatively, The Matrix as a sentimental journey into the last 20 odd years, 22 years. Oh my God, it was so bad. Oh Jesus, it was so bad. As an actress, Trinity is compelling. But here, no. It was boomery, like a boomer movie. And Neo was, I wouldn't call his acting bad, but it wasn't stellar either. It was,
his acting was bored.
He was bored. It felt as if he was bored. Like, it felt as like I'm doing some token things here, and I'm collecting money.
No, he felt like he just put on his pajamas, was out of bed, like, oh, what?
Like he woke him up.
Anderson, yes, that's me.
Okay, can someone run the lines again, or can I improvise a little? And it was. I can almost see like a heavily LSD in intoxicated Lana Wachowski yelling instructions from the back of the recording, and then everyone doing something, but it was, oh, I keep repeating how bad it was. So you have to keep in mind that this review is significantly better than The Matrix 4. The special effects here are significantly more compelling than The Matrix 4. How did this movie, which even mentions, like, Warner Bros., did they mention Warner Bros.?
Yeah.
They literally mention, yeah, we're going to make a sequel because Warner Brothers makes us make the sequel. Oh my God. That was a joke or something? What else would you qualify as really bad? And there's a lot. Pop.
Yes?
What else would you qualify as horribly bad?
The whole plot structure, like the and plot is used generously here, like
there's no plot. There is no plot. It is not. It is back like a romantic 80s sitcom. And that's about the plot. I think I've seen more plot in Friends episodes.
Mm-hmm.
What else?
Like the entire plot could be summed up into like Neo wakes up, sees Trinity, tells people about it, goes back and gets Trinity.
Yeah, and then they visit Zion, and it's now called Io.
It's not Zion.
And no, and it is no longer Zion, but it's Io, and oh my God, that's bad. It is like a Star Trek set from The Next Generation with some stuff. And all in all, you see like 15 people in Io. And there is a backdrop of puked CGI everywhere. and there's clouds and Disney birds there and funny character, little animated characters there, because the machines are now friendly, or many machines are friendly, but not all the machines are friendly, and even the unfriendly machines are just, I don't know, pathetic. Oh, Jesus. Oh my God. No, I will not talk about Matrix forever again. Don't go. Please don't go. The studios have to get a message that you cannot make stuff like this. This is not, this shouldn't be legal.